Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. This is New Jersey's First News for Monday, November 22nd. New Jersey's rate of transmission has continued its steady increase over the last couple of weeks and sits at 1.21 this morning. It is alarming to state health officials ahead of indoor gatherings for Thanksgiving and other holidays. When Governor Murphy gave up his sweeping pandemic powers last June, the legislature did allow him a path to reclaim those powers, and New Jersey's metrics are now above the threshold that would allow the governor to impose new mandates. Could be mask mandates on gatherings, possibly on travel. And while Murphy has not given any indication that he is ready to enact any new restrictions, the powers that he gave up can easily now be reclaimed with a rate of transmission above one. That was the threshold set by Democratic lawmakers when Governor Murphy formally ended the public health emergency that was declared at the beginning of the pandemic. I write more about this at NJ1015.com this morning. As the COVID pandemic continues, a growing number of New Jersey companies are imposing their own vaccine mandates or a weekly testing option. If you don't like either of those choices, the chances of you collecting unemployment if you're fired for noncompliance are slim. That from employment attorney Pete Frattarelli with the Archer Law Firm. He says if your company issues a vaccine mandate but no COVID testing option, you might qualify for unemployment, but adds that is still an open issue. We have expanded coverage on that at NJ1015.com this morning. Another armed road rage incident, this time in Brick, and police are asking for your help to identify a red pickup truck with an extended cab. Shots were fired from that vehicle into another vehicle. Nobody was hurt, but police did find a bullet inside the other vehicle last Thursday. Shots were reportedly fired at a car from a passing tractor-trailer on Route 78 in Warren County. A North Jersey community is grief-stricken this morning after the sudden death of a teenager who collapsed while practicing basketball in Bergen County. Dumont's mayor says grief counselors will be available for fellow students and school staff as needed. A GoFundMe campaign for surviving family has ID'd the boy as a 14-year-old. The Daily Voice reports he had collapsed at a local elementary school, CPR given immediately. He died at Hackensack University Medical Center. Gas prices held relatively steady in New Jersey and over the nation over the last week, but still, we are at levels not seen in 8 years. For a gallon of regular this morning, you'll pay on average $3.45. A year ago at this time, it was $2.21 a gallon. Oil prices have not retreated enough for us to see any significant decrease in gasoline prices. As the weather gets cooler, have you noticed some indoor invaders, ladybugs or Asian lady beetles? We're getting reports all over the Garden State of large clusters around windows or doors or anywhere in your home. Rutgers entomology experts say they're just trying to make it inside to stay warm. They really don't pose any threat to you. But if you want to keep them out, make sure your screens are tight and caulk around doors and windows, anywhere where they might be able to infiltrate your home. Also, time to start thinking about a Christmas tree. New Jersey has many offerings, Christmas tree farms across the Garden State, where they'll take a freshly cut tree and tie it to the roof of your car. You might even be able to go and cut your own. We have a list of some of New Jersey's best tree farms at NJ1015.com this morning. Have something to say about our top stories? Leave your comments right here. Please like and share this video. And remember, we're always taking your calls, talking Jersey on air on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's New Jersey's First News for this Monday, November 22nd. Have a great day.